This is a 100 amp hour battery, and this is also a 100 amp hour battery, but they're very clearly very different sizes. And the reason for that is because of the watt hours that is inside of each battery. Now, understanding the relationship between watt hours and amp hours is exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number 4 of this battery basics playlist. My name is Nate.
And I'm Steph.
And welcome to the Explorus Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Let's get started.
We get questions like this all the time. Why doesn't my 100 amp hour battery work for 100 hours?
So 100 amp hour battery, I mean, it doesn't work for 100 hours because it depends on, you know, how fast are you using the battery? How much power are you pulling from the battery at any given time? You know, if you're pulling 1 amp from your battery for 1 hour, that is what an amp hour is, you know, most easily defined as. If you had a 1 amp hour battery, I don't really think those exist, but if it did, if you had a 1 amp hour battery, that means that you would be able to pull 1 amp from it for 1 hour before that battery is totally drained. So here's a really good example of how that looks when you're pulling different amps from the batteries depending on the loads.
So the light bulb at 1 amp is a low powered load, and you could run that for 100 hours off of a 100 amp hour battery. The microwave at 100 amps, you could run for 1 hour for 100 amp hours. So what is a watt hour? A watt hour is 1 watt for 1 hour, similar to amp hours. But a watt is going to measure the amount of energy over time.
So really similarly to amp hours, if you have a 12 watt light bulb, and you're running that for 100 amp hours, that is 1200 watt hours. And similarly for the microwave, if it's a 1200 watt microwave, you can run that for 1 hour, and that's also going to pull 1200 watt hours from the battery bank.
So why is there a difference between amp hours and watt hours? We'll use the analogy of a fuel tank in a vehicle. So we've got a Prius with a 10 gallon fuel tank could potentially get you 400 miles on that 10 gallons, versus an F-150 with a 10-gallon fuel tank could get you about 200 miles. So with the same amount of fuel in the tank, that 10 gallons, you're going further with the Prius versus the F-150. Similarly with batteries, you're with a 12-volt battery at 100 amp hours, you'll have 1,200 watt hours. With a 24 volt battery at 100 amp hours, you get 2400 watt hours. So you get a higher output with the same capacity.
Another common misconception that we hear about from our customers is that a 100 amp hour battery at 24 volts is the same size and everything like that. Now remember earlier, we talked about the point of this is a 100 amp hour battery, and that is also a 100 amp hour battery. This top one, this top Battleborn battery here, is a 12 volt battery. And this Rich Solar rack style battery down here is a 48 volt battery. And this is why this is such a large battery in comparison to this battery. It's simply got 4 times as much capacity in it. So don't think that if you have a battery that's that size at 12 volts, if it was a 48 volt battery, it would all of a sudden still be the same size. Comparatively, a 12 volt battery and a 48 volt battery are going to be the same size if they have similar watt hours inside of them. Let's move forward and this will make more sense. So when we're comparing apples to apples here, we realistically need to find out what is the watt hours of any of these batteries behind me if we're trying to make a comparison on how much actual capacity is inside of each one. And to do that, pretty simple equation. We covered these back in an earlier chapter of the Academy in formulas, but we're going to go ahead and recover that now because it just makes a lot of sense. So the formula for converting from amp hours to watt hours is you take the amp hours of the battery, you multiply it by the voltage of the battery, and that gives you the watt hours output. Now, so for example, that Battleborn 12 volt battery over there, it's got a 100 amp hour capacity in it. And so that's going to give us 1200 watt hours of battery capacity. Now, if we wanted to go from watt hours back to amp hours, then we would just sort of reverse that around. So we'd take watt hours divided by volts, and then that would give us our amp hours. And so anytime you're trying to compare the actual capacity of these batteries, you know, that may be a 12 volt battery at 100 amp hours. This may be a 48 volt battery at 100 amp hours. This battery over here, the Epoch batteries, they actually come in a 12 volt, a 24 volt, and a 48 volt version of 460 amp hours at 12 volts. 230 amp hours at 24 volts and 115-ish at 48 volts. So you compare the watt hours for all of these, and that's going to give you the actual apples to apples comparison for how much capacity is inside of these batteries. And this graphic really hopefully hammers that concept home. A 100 amp hour battery at 12 volts is 1200 watt hours. A 100 amp hour battery at 24 volts is 2400 watt hours. A 100 amp hour at 48 volts is 4800 watt hours. So you can see that just because it's all 100 amp hours, the capacity of a 48 volt battery at 100 amp hours is significantly larger.
So let's use a real world example of a 100 watt laptop used for 5 hours from a 12 volt battery bank. So we're going to take our 100 watts times 5 hours is 500 watt hours. 500 watt hours divided by 12 volts is 41.67 amp hours. So to run our 100 watt laptop for 5 hours, we need about 42 amp hours.
And to make that sort of make sense on a what will it take out of one of these batteries, if that's a 100 amp hour battery, if we drain 41.67 amp hours from that 100 amp hour battery, it's going to drain it to from 100% to, you know, just shy of 50%. Now, all these figures and calculations and stuff like that, this is really important for determining what size of battery bank you need in your system. And the size of the battery bank is going to be determined by, you know, determining your daily watt hour needs. Now, we're not going to cover that in depth in this video because we spent a whole playlist of this academy teaching you how to do a power audit and how much power various devices use. But once you understand that and get that information, then you're going to be able to figure out what battery size that you need. Now, it's not really that important that you're using, you know, that battery right there or this battery here or that battery way over there because they're all different capacities. The main thing is to get the overall watt hours you're going to use on a day-to-day basis, and then make sure that your battery bank capacity is enough to cover that need, regardless of if it's one of those batteries or 12 of these batteries or 4 of these batteries. You know, we can really configure these in any sort of, you know, configuration we need to meet these demands. And then from there, you can take the watt hours used in the battery bank and watt hours you're planning on using on a day-to-day basis. And then you can determine your other charging sources like solar, because there's a relationship between solar recharging and battery bank capacity, so that you're making sure that you give your solar panels the best chance of recharging those batteries, you know, all however many thousands of watt hours you may have. And once you figure out the watt hours of the battery bank, you can take that, divide that number by 6, and then that's sort of a rule of thumb of how much solar wattage it'll take to recharge those batteries on a day-to-day basis. So if you only take away one concept from this whole video, it's this. It's the understanding that a 100 amp hour battery can be different watt hours depending on what the voltage of the battery is. So 100 amp hour battery at 12 volts equals 1200 watt hours. 100 amp hour battery at 24 volts equals 2400 watt hours. And 100 amp hour battery at 48 volts equals 4800 watt hours. And to realize this in a real world scenario that's really, really important for everybody is how long can it power a blender? Because it's really important to be able to power your blender. Because if you run out of power while you're trying to power a blender, the party goes away and then it's no fun. So a 1200 watt blender run for 1 hour, that will pull 1200 watt hours from a battery. And same thing for the other remaining blenders. So That pretty much wraps up this video. In the next video, we're going to cover the differences between 12 volts, 24 volts, and 48 volt systems in terms of which one do you actually need for your needs in your off-grid electrical system. We'll see you over there.